So yeah, it's been a while since the last episode, but it's flu season and my voice was not suitable for recording anything. But in the meantime, we hit over 100 subscribers, and as they say, it ain't much, but it's honest work. So I prepared something special for today. I'm gonna show you the first backstage I've ever recorded, without GoPros, DJIs, filmed only with my old iPhone, which turned out to be the best camera I had at the time. But this episode is special for one more reason. All photos were shot on DSLR. While aimlessly scrolling through Instagram, I came across this post. I sent it to Doris, and after a few days, she replied with a picture of winter skates, captioned, "Look what I've just bought." She wrote this message in Polish, so you have to believe me. Talking about the cover, which was our inspiration, it's probably one of the most iconic Playboy covers, and one of the best if you ask me. It was released in April 1991, and the model is Julie Clarke.
And what am I supposed to say?
Julie Clarke.
Who was on Playboy Center for just a month before and became a playmate of Merge. It was also quite a good session. The set was built to look like an old diner with jukebox and things like that. And Julie's story may sound like an American dream, because she was noticed by a Playboy photographer at Venus Swimwear Model Search, and after a test shoot she made centerfold and cover. But her height was not enough to get into real fashion modeling, so she made only some videos for Playboy, some car commercials, and quit modeling for a while. In the meantime, Julie started skydiving. She worked as an assistant to sushi chef and as paralegal for several attorneys. She returned to modeling in 2004. Now she's running her own website with some special content for members, which looks quite vintage but seems to be still updated. So back to our photoshoot. The plan was to make it as kitschy as possible, to capture the ambience of the early 90s, and I happened to have a mystery suitcase with a bunch of fashion jewelry, some cheap colorful bags and plastic watches, which Doris seemed to enjoy quite a lot. Technically, the set was pretty simple, a white background with two strobes pointed directly at it to get rid of shadows and grays, and another two flashes with soft boxes for the model. While I was setting everything, Doris dropped herself with all the glitter, so after checking the styling and quick selfie, we were ready to shoot. And I was so impressed with this look that I had to kneel before Her Majesty first. So the thing about this Julie Clarke photoshoot is that you can find only 3 shots from this session, except this one on the cover. And they were not in the April issue at all, at least in the US version, which I found in PDF format. Same cover was used also in a special Sporty Girls edition, but there are also no Julie's pictures. But anyway, we tried to recreate what we had.
Thank you.
Don't try, don't try to deny it.
And it turned out really great. I was shooting with Canon 5D Mark III with 24-70 Sigma lens, and all the photos were taken at 70mm, but I wanted to try a wider angle. Yeah, this one's my favorite for sure. Well, I'm so satisfied with these shots. We didn't just copy Julie's photos one to one, we created our own interpretation, and after all these years I still love this photo shoot. So I want to thank you for supporting me, for all those subs, likes and comments, and please let me know what you think about digital content on this channel. And well, I hope we're gonna make the next special for 1000 subscribers. So, one more time, thank you for being here and see you in the next video.